Hello and welcome to the final real estate report for 2013. We're in front of D'Urienzo's at the corner of Beach Street and Champagne, I think it is. Some people call this a hole in the wall. Some people call it a cultural institution. I call it a great sandwich shop. In that place, you'll have a lineup that goes around a couple of different aisles and out the front door if you're not here in time. They serve fabulous, fabulous sandwiches and pasta, by the way, for only $5. So if you're in here, you can get that, a great spicy samosa or whatever. So other than that, the real estate, again, this is the end of November, and it's the last one we'll be doing for the year. And what happened in November is that residential sales were down about 1% and condominium sales were down 15%. Big whack. And it took 55 days for a house to sell and 56 days for a condo to sell. So let's wrap it all up. What's gone on so far this year? Well, for residential properties, their sales are down about 2% over last year, and prices are up 2%. And that's the same thing we've been saying for the past few months. So if you're looking to buy a house, the average price is $382,000 for a property in Ottawa. For condominiums, they continue to take a beating. Their sales over the course of the year are down 7% compared to last year, and prices are down about 2%. In terms of, oh, by the way, the average price for a condo is $264,000. Now, if you're looking to buy one of these, you do have more property to look at. The inventory levels for residential is up 3%, and that means that there's now 4,500 homes for sale. For condominiums, inventory levels are up 15%, and there's now 1,600 condominiums on the market for sale in Ottawa. So that's it. If you have any questions, if you're looking to get your house on the market early in 2014, Patrick Walchuk, 613-788-2590. Thank you.